Luigi Gubitosi, welcome to INSEAD Knowledge.
Thank you for having me.
It seems as though your appointment as the Director General of RAI is a bit of a reform in itself. I mean, you have a strong background in industry with Fiat, Wind, Bank of America, Merrill Lynch. Why did they choose you?
Well, I guess the idea was to bring somebody from the private sector to insert a private sector mentality, or rather to have a public sector company to steer towards competence and merit as the main drivers of careers in the company, and to bring some expertise in a turnaround as the company is having a difficult period, considering the context of the Italian economy these days.
I'm just wondering, what is on your list of things to do? What kind of reforms are you looking to make? Maybe your top three. I'm sure it's a long list.
Basically, if I had to tell you three objectives that we have, is to have an excellent offer from an editorial point of view, to be state-of-the-art in terms of technology, to have to reach stability in financial terms, to have equilibrium in our accounts. But obviously, what I'm going to work beside in industrial plan is to have a turnaround in corporate culture and in organization.
Now, RAI, I believe, just came out with its industrial plan. These are part of the plan. Can you amplify that a little bit? Tell us a little bit more about what it's about.
In fact, yes, we did approve yesterday the business plan for the next 3 years, and it will go through an update, and in fact, to bring state-of-the-art our technology, our studios, the way we work, and revisiting completely the processes. And we basically identified a number of areas which are key to be reformed or improved in order to bring back in black the accounts, while at the same time to improve our offer and maintain a leading market share in terms of viewers in Italy.
So what kinds of things will you work on first when you say things that need to be improved?
Well, the way we plan our operations, so we have to treat our production center as factories in terms of schedules in order to be effective and efficient in production. We're working on the overall offer that we provide. We now operate 14 channels in Italy, plus an international channel. And that's probably the largest offer by a European broadcaster.
This brings up a lot of things. Competition. You have Murdoch, who's a new entry, and of course you have the Mediaset people who've been there for a while. How do you compete with these people? Is it sports? Is it video on demand?
Well, it's as usual, you compete by trying to do things better than your competitors, especially being more effective and offering products that people like better than your competitors. Our recent results are quite encouraging in that respect. We have a commanding share of the Italian market, about 40%, and it seems that we're holding on well. I think, as a matter of fact, I think we are the public broadcaster with the largest share in Europe.
You do have a large audience share, as a matter of fact. How do you see that growing, or which sector is going to grow most? I mean, you've got all these different platforms.
Well, we have a number of what we call specialized channels, so movie channels or fiction, kids and so on and so forth, which are growing nicely, while the so-called generalist TV tends to decline in long term because of the very large offer. Italy is now the European country which I believe has the most offer, the largest free offer. Mm. So it's a pretty competitive market. You have to be very careful not to lose touch with your viewers.
Do you?
Having said that, let me add that I won't mind if we lose a couple of points in terms of shares, but if we do TV, quality TV, I think we should be interested in quality, not only in quantity of viewers, quality of programs, because we are anyway a public sector company, we're a public service, and this should never forget.
So would you would do fewer quiz shows, for example, maybe, and more drama, or what would
well,
you do?
Well, you know, we work on basically on journalistic reports, as well as you know, we promote, for example, the image of the women in a different way as in the past, or we'll do the legality day to remind people that there are still improvements that can be done in fighting crime, especially in certain parts of Italy, as well as in general, you know, RAI had a big function in educate the country in the 60s, and we want to be back in being very different from commercial TV in that respect. I think what BBC said in the past it was, you know, i.e. the role of TV is to educate, inform, entertain is still very valid.
Let me just ask about money. I mean, at about 2005, I guess there was a thought about privatizing at least part of RAI. Are you thinking about doing that now?
I don't think it's on the agenda anytime soon.
That sounds pretty definite. How about advertising? I mean, it's not a good time at all in general. How are you going to get more ads? Or how are you going to get more revenue?
We're going to be, and we are actually, improving our competitiveness in that respect. We are becoming more sophisticated, and we're trying to educate our clients to become more sophisticated. We're having some early success. Having said that, in 2012, and I believe also in 2013, advertising in Italy has gone down dramatically and will continue to do so for a while.
Overall, what's your view for RAI? Now, you've got a three-year mandate, it's renewable. What do you hope to achieve?
Well, 3 years seems like a pretty long time. as I say, I'd like that by the time the 3 years expire, I leave a much better ride than I found, and with its account in order, technology fully updated, state-of-the-art, and a high quality in the programming.
It's a big job. How did INSEAD prepare you for that? I mean, we're here at an INSEAD alumni event where you were just speaking, and everybody seems to be very enthusiastic.
Well, I was at INSEAD a long time ago. I was a young fellow back then. I was 24 when I did INSEAD. And I found a great experience, which taught me a lot. I think it used me to diversity. We have people from many countries working hard, and it gave me skills to be adapting flexibility. I still remember our organizational behavior classes. I had Professor Ketz de Vries, which had a big impact on me, and often I quote him on some of the lessons. So I learned a lot at INSEAD, and I think he made me a better manager.
Luigi Gubitosi, thank you very much for being with us on INSEAD Knowledge.
Thank you.